हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ मिसेस अर्चना म्हात्रे, लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेलीकम्युनिकेशन डिपार्टमेंट. वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द फर्स्ट यूनिट ऑफ ईएमआई, फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मेजरमेंट. द लर्निंग आउटकम्स ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज लर्नर्स विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड डायनामिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक, एरर्स इन मेजरमेंट एंड टाइप्स ऑफ एरर. Now, in the first video, we will define the dynamic characteristic of an instrument. The dynamic characteristic, that means the characteristic which is variable, which is changes with respective time. That means these characteristic are not fixed, changes with respective time, then that characteristic is of an instrument is called as the dynamic characteristic. Now, in static characteristic, we will see many characteristic in static, but in dynamic only four characteristic are there. First is speed of response, fidelity, lag and dynamic error. We will see the definition of one by one characteristic. First is the speed of response. It is the rapidity with which the instrument respond to the changes in the measured quantity is called as the speed of the response. Measure quantity is nothing but your input. That means the rapidity with which the instrument respond. That means your instrument, how fast your instrument is respond to the input, it is nothing but the speed of response. That means your input, if your input is slightly changes, then your output should be changes. Next characteristic is fidelity. Fidelity, it is the degree with which instrument indicates the change in measured value without dynamic error. The degree with which the instrument indicates change in measured value. Here you can decide the change in measured value, that means change in input value, but while measuring, while indicating the change in measuring value, that is input, your dynamic error should be zero. That characteristic is called as the fidelity of an instrument. Next characteristic is lag. It is the degree in this it is the delay in response of an instrument to make changes in the measured quantity is called as the lag of an instrument. That means if you changes the input for some time, your instrument does not respond. It does not shows the output. So what delay it can take to show the output, that is nothing but your lag of an instrument. The delay in response of an instrument to make changes in the measured quantity, that delay is called as the lag of an instrument. Now next characteristic is dynamic error. It is the difference between the true value of the quantity with time and the value indicated by instrument if no static error is assumed. We will define the static error in the earlier video. The static error definition is the difference between the true value and the measured value is called as static error. But here dynamic error, how you can define? The dynamic error is also the difference between the true value and the measured value, but the measured quantity is changes with respective time. And in static, while calculating the dynamic error, your static error should be assumed to be zero. Now next, is the errors in the measurement and type of error. Here the characteristic topic is over. Next topic is error in the measurement. Now what is the error in the measurement? Error is the difference between the observed value and the true value. True value is which value? The value comes from the standard instrument. That value is called as true value. And the observed value, that is measured value, the value coming from the measuring instrument, that value is called as the observed value. The difference between these two can be calculated as an error. Study of an error is important as a step of finding, as a step in finding ways of reducing them. If you want to reduce the error, then you have to first identify what error will come from the measurement. The errors may originate in a variety of ways. Now, different type of errors that occur in measurement have been classified into the three categories. First category is gross error, systematic error, and then random errors. Systematic error again classified into instrumental error, environmental error, and observational error. So, types of error, there are three main errors, that is gross error, systematic error, and a random error. We will see these errors one by one. First, we will see what is gross error. These errors occurs due to human mistake in reading or using instrument and in recording and calculating measurement result are known as the gross error. That means the gross error can be generated because of the human mistake. For example, the experimenter may read the reading as 31.5 degrees Celsius instead of 21.5 degrees Celsius. That means the reading which the instrument shows is 21.5, and the human, that is experimenter, will record the reading, will read the reading as 31.5 degrees Celsius. That means it is a human mistake. That error is generated from the human mistake is called as a gross error. Next, while recording, he may read 28.5 degrees Celsius and record as a 21.5 degrees Celsius. Then error will be generated. That error is called as a gross error. Now, how you can avoid these errors? This error can be avoided by taking great care of an reading and recording the data. Great care should be taken in reading and recording the data. That is the only way to reduce the gross error. Human should be take care of the readings of the instrument while recording and reading. Now next errors are the systematic errors. Now the systematic errors are divided into three categories, that are instrumental error, environmental error, and the observational error. Instrumental error are due to shortcoming of instruments. Environmental errors are due to external condition affecting the instrument. And the observational errors are because of the observing the reading of an instrument. Now we will see the instrumental error. Even if humans are avoided, or proper human errors are avoided, or proper care is taken to see that such errors do not occur, errors can still occur in measurement due to instrument. The possible reason can be as follows. First is friction of bearings of various moving components can cause incorrect reading. Then irregular spring tension in analog meters, which are pointers meter. Then calibration errors, zero setting not adjusted properly. Then full scale setting not adjusted properly. Then faulty display circuit in digital instrument. These are the reasons why the instrumental errors are occur. Now, how it can be reduced? These error can be avoided by selecting suitable instrument and calibrating the instrument properly. Next error is environmental error. Environmental error, these error are due to external conditions to the measuring device. It is depending on the external condition. Ambient parameters such as temperature, pressure, humidity, magnetic and electrostatic field, dust and other such external parameters can affect the performance of an instrument. And because of that, the error occurs, which are called as an environmental error. Now, how this error should be avoided? Such errors can be avoided by air conditioning, magnetic shielding, cleaning the instrument and housing the instrument properly depending on the application and type of the instrument. Now, next error, systematic error is observational error. Observational error, it occurs because of the observation of the human. Even when an instrument has been properly selected, carefully installed and faithfully calibrated, shortcoming in the measurement occurs due to a certain failing on the part of observer. The observational error causes due to parallax, that is, error arises on account of pointer and scale not being on the same plane. That means if you are using the analog meters which has a pointer to show the reading, in analog meter this observational error mainly occurs. So to avoid these errors, to avoid the error, we can use the digital meters instead of the analog meters. Such errors can be avoided by using modern electrical instrument having the digital display. If there is digital display, then there is no need. The errors does not occur because of the observational. Okay. These are the systematic errors. Now, last error is your random error, also called as the residual error. Now, random error is, though gross errors and systematic errors can be avoided by taking a proper care, some other errors can be occur in measurement. No specific reason can be assigned and precaution could be taken to avoid these errors. Such errors are categorized as a random error. That means you will see we will see the gross error and the systematic error. If we taking a good care, proper care to avoid the gross error as well as the systematic error, then also the error should be occur. We don't know what is the reason behind this, and such error is called as the random error or residual error. So these are the types of errors. Three mainly type we have seen: gross error, systematic error and the random error. In systematic error, we have seen the instrumental error, observational error and the environmental error. Okay. Thank you.